Hey guys, welcome. It's the New Jersey Craft Beer Review, our first ever episode. We're so excited. Our first beer that we're going to be checking out is River Horse Cranberry Sour Beer. And with me tonight, our esteemed panel, I'm Chris Swenderman from the Bill Spadia Show. I got my man Chris Anucci here from the Big Joe Henry Show, Frank Cerdo, and to our far end, Dan Tantillo, producer of the Dennis and Judy Show. All right, gentlemen, what do you say? Should we get right into it?
Let's pour us up some beer?
Let's do it.
Open these. While we're pouring, you have the beer notes.
Sure.
On the website, right?
So the River Horse Cranberry Sour is a sour wheat ale aged in white wine barrels. The addition of New Jersey cranberries adds a complexity and tart flavors, plus a hazy pink color. The ABV is 4.6%.
All right, so we're already seeing the hazy pink, like a grayish pink.
Yep.
Right, would you say?
Yep.
And you can smell the sourness.
Definitely. Smell right away.
Yeah, you can smell as soon as you start pouring it.
Thank you.
All right, so pretty cool artwork. We have our other camera here. The hippopotamus, the river horse, right?
The river horse hippo.
The river horse.
And I'll show you the color here. About a finger or two of white foam. We got a little bit more head than you guys.
Yep.
A little bit
so
more.
Let's smell it. So you get that funk, that tartness funk.
Yeah, right off the bat.
Have you guys had sour beers?
I personally haven't.
No, I haven't actually tried a sour beer.
So Frank's a home brewer,
That's right.
I'm definitely into the New Jersey craft beer, and you guys are kind of your average New Jersey beer drinkers, right?
Yeah, yep, definitely, absolutely. Definitely go and try to find the New Jersey craft beers and test them out as much as you can, but I definitely don't know as much. I just like drinking.
So this is a good,
this is good
experience.
Exactly.
Absolutely. Sure.
All right, let's give it a try. Right. So tart.
Very tart.
Yeah.
Definitely, the tart hits you right away.
You can get a little bit of the cranberry.
Yeah, it's got a little cranberry taste. So you're pretty dry on the finish.
Very dry. Almost more like a wine.
I was just about to
say.
Yeah, exactly. You definitely have that wine.
And it's aged in the white wine barrels in oak. Do you get a little bit of oakiness?
Yeah, a little bit.
Does that change at all in being in oak barrels as opposed to what would normal beers be housing and aged?
I mean, most of them aren't aged. They're just
not put away in barrels at all.
Yeah, they're in stainless steel.
Okay.
What would you call it? Fermenting.
Right.
Yeah, like a fermenting tank.
So this is definitely unique. This is a very limited run. And when I picked this up about a month ago when I was writing a post for the 10 must try fall beers. So we'll put that in the description below if you want to check that out. But when I was picking this up, they only had a few left, so this is going to be pretty hard to find. But why don't we finish this up, and we'll come back with our final thoughts.
All right. So, gentlemen, final thoughts. Yay or nay? Thumbs up, thumbs down?
I think, as it warmed up, it was still enjoyable. There was that funkiness, but... You know, I really enjoyed it. What about first-time sour drinkers?
Yeah, this is definitely something different than I've ever had in a beer before, but I think I'd get it again. It's definitely something different, and I think you kind of have to be in the mood for it, but especially around this time of the year, I'm all about it.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely for a fall time of the year, you know, like talking right after Thanksgiving, fall, this is a great beer. I would definitely try it again, for sure.
I'm definitely thumbs up, glass up, whatever you want to call it.
Me too.
Same.
Yep, I agree. It's definitely a special occasion beer, but I really enjoyed it.
Now this was a super limited release, so it's probably gonna be hard to find. But Dan, you have
River Horse is distributed by Hunterdon Brewing Company. It's available in all counties in New Jersey, but can also be found in Connecticut, Pennsylvania, as well as New York. Right now, it's currently on tap as of today, which is November 29th. It is on tap at Capital Craft in Greenbrook Township, New Jersey.
All right, guys. Well, thanks so much for watching our inaugural episode. If you like what you see, click the like button, subscribe at NJ1015, and make sure you check us out on NJ1015.com as well. Cheers, New Jersey.
Cheers. Cheers. Cheers.